Fasting is practiced in almost every major religious tradition, including Buddhism, Islam, Hinduism, Christianity, and Judaism. In ancient Greece, Hippocrates believed that fasting helped the body heal itself. During Ramadan, many Muslims fast from dawn to sunset every day for a month. Another form of fasting called intermittent fasting has become popular as a weight loss method. Scientists have gathered a lot of information about what happens to your body during fasting, and the findings are mostly positive. When you fast, your body goes through the fed-fast cycle, which is characterized by changes in your metabolism and hormone levels. This cycle is not only responsible for the metabolic changes during intermittent fasting, but also contributes to its health benefits. There are multiple stages of fasting, and the benefits you get from fasting depend on the length of your fast. Here's an overview of the five main stages of fasting and the specific benefits associated with each stage. Stage 1. The first 4 hours after eating is considered the anabolic phase. This means your body is busy building tissue, especially muscle. It takes the nutrients from your food and uses them to grow tissue. Your pancreas makes insulin to help move sugar from your blood and store extra sugar as fat. If you're on a low-carb, high-fat diet like keto, your body uses fat for energy instead of sugar. When you eat, your blood sugar goes up, so your body releases insulin to keep your energy levels steady. Stage 2. After about 12 hours of fasting, your body begins to enter the early stages of ketosis. This means it stops using carbohydrates for energy and starts burning stored body fat instead. This phase is important for those who practice intermittent fasting because it triggers certain health benefits, like lowering blood pressure and improving insulin sensitivity. This can be particularly helpful for people with type 2 diabetes or other issues related to blood sugar control. In your body, the anabolic process breaks down stored glucose in the liver and muscles, as well as fat stored in your body, to provide energy for various bodily functions. If you're eating a high-carb diet, your body starts burning fat towards the end of a 16-hour fasting period. But if you eat a generally low-carb, high-fat diet, your body will already be in a ketogenic state. In this case, stage 2 will serve to enhance this ketogenic state. If you don't often do intermittent fasting, you can enhance fat burning by reducing carb intake and increasing consumption of fatty whole foods 1 to 3 days before fasting. After that, your body starts a process called autophagy. Autophagy means self-eating is a cellular process responsible for repairing and renewing cells. During autophagy, the body cleans out misfolded proteins and damaged organelles, while also removing harmful infectious bacteria and viruses such as mycobacterium, tuberculosis, streptococcus, mycotoxins, and herpes. Stage 3. Stage 3 is your primary fat-burning and autophagic phase. Most people's bodies will be completely depleted of energy from food. Your glycogen will be used up, and your metabolism will have made the transition into ketosis. During this period, an energy-sensing enzyme called AMPK gets fully triggered, activating gene expressions that promote more autophagy. Research on 24-hour fasts has shown that they can boost human growth hormone, HGH, levels significantly. In men, HGH levels can increase by a factor of 20, while in women, the increase is typically around 13 times higher. Higher levels of serum HGH are associated with better memory, increased muscle mass, less water retention, and a reduction in the stress hormone cortisol. Stage 4. After fasting for a full day, your body starts repairing itself. It begins to recycle old or damaged cells and reduces inflammation. After 48 hours of fast, you're leaving intermittent fasting territory and entering a longer fast. As you undertake multiple days of fasting, your growth hormone levels begin to shift, which provides you with a new set of benefits. A study of healthy adults found that 48-hour fasting increased human growth hormone secretion by up to 400%. It also increased the frequency of growth hormone bursts throughout the day. HGH increases muscle mass and stimulates faster muscle repair. It may also speed up the healing process for wounds and more serious injuries. HGH is so effective that its external use is prohibited in professional sports and is classified as doping. It might sound surprising, but sometimes not eating for 2 days can actually help you gain muscle instead of losing it. Stage 5. When you fast for more than 72 hours, it's considered prolonged fasting. Most prolonged fasts typically last up to 5 days. During stage 5, your liver reduces the production of a hormone called IGF-1, which triggers stem cell production. A 2014 study found that 72-hour fasting led to a near-complete rejuvenation of the immune system. Fasting triggered stem cell production, which then created new immune cells to replace the old ones. In the same study, cancer patients were asked to fast while undergoing chemotherapy treatment. Typically, chemotherapy weakens the immune system, making cancer patients more vulnerable to infections and illnesses. However, when patients fasted during chemotherapy, their immune system remained strong throughout the treatment. Before we end the video, I want to give you a kind piece of advice. If you are going to start fasting and want the best outcomes, consider following the Muslim method of fasting. They fast every day from dawn to sunset for almost a month, which can completely transform a person's health and body. These are the scientific benefits of Ramadan fasting, the health benefits of fasting during Ramadan, and the psychological benefits of fasting during Ramadan.